doing. There's a couple of new tools also here. This is, as you see, this works like freehand. With freehand, you can resize directly here, or you can rotate skew if you click again over the object. This is to edit the object by nodes. You can add nodes, you can remove nodes, you can edit the nodes that already existed, and this is something great on this software. You can create the so famous rectangle with the rounded as easy as move, drag the mouse. Cool, right? This is another new thing in the software. This work like liquify, and it's really, really, really cool. Look at this. I'm going to liquify this. For example, if I want to create like a ink splat here, just see what can I do with this tool. And you gotta remember, this is a vector image. I'm not working with bitmap here. You can control the force. Good, great, huh? If you used to Adobe Photoshop, you see that liquify made the same thing, just to try to mix an object with another layer or something. And we have the gradient tool, the zoom tool, we had the create 3D box tool. It's pretty neat, huh? And you can control the position, you can control the view. This is good for to create icons for Windows Vista. You can use this as a reference to create your icons. It's really cool. Something that in Adobe Illustrator they have something alike, but it's not that effective like that one. You get for create circles or polygons, stars and polygons, surreals, freehand. I'm going to show you how to use this today. Calligraphic lines, fill, text, and gradient edition. Okay, now that you know mostly about this, let's go to here. When you click on the fill, yep, this will pop up. Here on the fill, you can control the color by RGB, hue, saturation, and lining, by hue, saturation, and lining, by CMYK, by the wheel of color, or by CMS. Most of the time, you're going to use this, the RGB or the CMYK, if you're going to make something for prepress, CMYK. Okay, for the web, this is the most common. Okay, I'm going to show you something now, so really quick. Here, as you see, this work like any other vector software. You get the nodes and the lines. You can break nodes here. I'm going to show you how. If you want to break a node, create a node, just click on shift and hold it while you dragging the mouse, and with the right click apply to, and you can move that, and you see it's really cool. It's really cool. Okay, as you see now, this object is only half stroke. If I want to add a fill, the only thing I have to do is select a color right down here, or just click here, and it's going to fill with the same color that I have, but I want it white, so I change it to white. Or let me undo Control C, the same as any of, if I want to change that, I'm going to move this and this and this, and you have a white. I want to remove the color of the stroke. You can control the stroke here, and that's really neat. You can apply gradient to the stroke. You can apply a gradient to nothing, to transparency also here in this software, and it's really cool too. Okay, I get this. I want to add a gradient. Alright, I got that gradient, and I can edit the gradient with these nodes. You see, I can move this around, and voila, it create me this glass effect here, like the reflection of the light that comes from above. Now this, I'm gonna apply Control C, that's copy, Control Alternate V, paste in place, and you see the white square that we draw disappear. Don't worry, that's because it pastes in place, but in front of everything. Just we're going to move this to the bottom, lower selection to the bottom, and we're going to change the color to totally black. And what I'm going to show you now is really cool. I move the object with the arrows in the keyboard as you like, and I'm going to create a shadow for this. This how it easy to create effects in the software, and opacity, transparency, and there it is. It's really neat. Later on, I'm going to show you how to create a glass ball and a glass effect button for your web page or any of your design. Well, everyone, this is all for today. Thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe to the newsletters if you're not subscribed yet, at www.rapiee.com, www.rapiee.com. Thank you for watching. Have a blessed day. Bye.
Faso kanu ni horonya ye.